Hi everybody, it's me, Bella Landry. I am drinking Bigelow tea today in my living room. And I am just doing so well, but I have something to share with everybody. It's something gigantic that I did recently last year, 2023. And it was so good. And I did the James Dean story, and it was really smart of me. And it was when I was 25 years old and living in Paradise Valley after I came back from Mesa, Arizona. And I was living in a place called the Paradise Manor. And here it goes, okay? I'm so happy about it. And it's very cool too. Okay, this is it. The James Dean story, the modern one. It says, "Keep your head up." And I wrote this, okay? I did it. So here we go. Once upon a time, from 46th Street and Thunderbird, a red Mustang was parked on Thunderbird and Tatum, and James Dean was in a blue vintage car and it broke, so he parked it and started walking. He walks back to Thunderbird and Tatum. So he's sitting on a stone bench in the English town and he has to rest. The red Mustang is gone and he was bored. He walks to Circle K and buys a black and white Red Bull and a pack of cigarettes and a lighter. 3 days later, he's on another walk in a really far away out place. He finds Tatum and Greenway. On the left side of the street, he sees Paradise Manor. He crosses to the right side of the street and finds an apple cookie in the trash can. He eats it, and it's delicious. He finds a red resting bench and rests. Him and his mom move into a Paradise Manor house. He throws on a white t-shirt and jeans and walks to his resting bench. He's now more familiar with Greenway and he's happy. 52nd Street and Greenway is an intersection and he crosses the street to go back home and smokes a Camel cigarette. He goes home and his mom takes the cigarettes from him. He's mad and the sullen, cloudy night is enough for him, so he walks. So he walks from his house in the manor and he walks across the sidewalk out of the Paradise Manor and turns left. And the story goes, James Dean died at age 24, and at age 25, I completed his story. It was just me and my father and his Marlboro cigarettes. And eventually, when I was 19, I smoked all the Marlboro cigarettes I could possibly want. So here's the rest of the story. James Dean's ghost is sitting on a grass field across from 5025 in Paradise Manor. And I was living in Paradise Manor when I got back from Mesa, Arizona. And I was living at the pink house. And what happened was I walked out of the Paradise Manor and I turned left on Greenway Street. And I walked across the street and I walked all the way down Greenway Street in a very big rectangle form. And I walked into the town, and this is a skill that is really high in the world to know about town, and it's a skill that I've been doing for a long time. So, here we are on Greenway and Tatum in Paradise Valley, Arizona, and the way into the town I took was on the sidewalk, and this was a resting bench, and I walked down the sidewalk, and this is the rest of the James Dean story, and then I'm gonna trip back into my story. He sits on a bench, James Dean, and he rests after a long walk. James Dean walks home and passes by a tiny sidewalk that he stands on and looks out of the parking lot before him. So he's standing on the sidewalk and he looks at this sidewalk parking lot. And it's a cigarette box in the shape of a handicap symbol. Then he pulls a mail letter out of his back pocket and he puts it in the mailbox in the parking lot and then he walks home. He stops on the corner and looks at 50/25 and is tired. Okay, so then I'm going to go back to my story. So there's a red resting bench in the town, and I'm walking the sidewalk, and I walk down past the dollar store, and I stumble down the street, and I hop on top of the tiny sidewalk, and I'm looking out, and it's a handicap symbol because when I walk too far, I look at the symbol for myself, and it is me in a handicap chair, which is also has another meaning that's really iconic. So that's me. I'm Bella Landry. And so I walked across the sidewalks towns, and I hop on top of the tiny sidewalk, and I look out and I see the handicap symbol, and it's in the shape of a cigarette box. And that is like the most iconic thing I've ever found. So that's really good. And so if you walk across the handicap symbol cigarette box, there's a mailbox, and that's where you can put mail, where James Dean would put his mail as like his ghost, which is really, really cool. And then he would walk on the sidewalk and then walk down Greenway, and there's tall pine trees all along Greenway, which is why the street is called Greenway. And I love this story because in the end, this shape is created and it's really like just really clean and sleek. So I'm gonna show you guys like the drawing because, okay, it's super dopey, don't judge me. If you smoke cigarettes, you're not gonna be like a world-renowned artist. Like, let me try real fast. So this is like this tiny little stick figure in a drawing, and you can see the shape of the street. So here's the house, and so he walks out of this and then up this, down this, and if you walk across here, you can see there's like more going on in town. This is a red bench, and then if you stand here and look down, you can see the handicap symbol that's in the shape of a cigarette box. And then this is a mailbox, very classic navy blue. And then if you turn in your mail after, you know, smoking a cigarette on the bench or whatever, this is the town itself. And then you leave town and you walk down this way, and there's tall pine trees. Oh wait, down, hold on. So I made this line, but it's actually just like back this way. You're gonna be on this side of the street again. And then he comes down this way, and then what I found is when I came back from this walk, I sat down here, and this is like what's completing the James Dean story. Is that he died when he was 24, but when I did the James Dean walk and I found it, I was 25. So if you sit right here and you look across the street of this location, you can see the address 50/25, and I think that's really, really cool. So that's what I did in the James Dean story, and then I made the end of it because I kept walking around because I don't know. I was just being a sidewalker person. And I think that's fun. So let's finish the good part of the story. So here it goes. He walks too far, so he buys another black and white Red Bull, a symbol for death. The end of your life when you pass away, it's from black to white. So I just added these props because this is something I personally found. A black Red Bull and then a white Red Bull, and to avoid death, I drank them to keep myself alive. It's a really dark tale. That's what I'm working on now, and it's called The New Time Story. So he avoids death by drinking a black and white Red Bull, and he tells himself he doesn't want to die. So that's what he thinks. And then he moves to Waterford on Greenway, and he buys a Ford Mustang in red. Then he buys water. He meets, I called the woman a honey. That's a big, bold word, so you can like really hear what I'm saying. A honey, and they walk from Tatum to 52nd Street and back home. In 52nd Street, it's like, okay, let's get that. He picks up smoking cigarettes again, and his honey takes them from him. So they marry each other, and they live a good life in the village that's down the street from Tatum and Greenway, from their old apartment. Now they live in Village Square with one kid who moved out, because he was an adult. James Dean and his honey dine at the Oint Cafe every Saturday, and they split chorizo breakfast nachos and hot coffee, and they love it when it rains because he can sit on the patio and look out at the weather and drink Diet Coke and smoke cigarettes. Eventually, James Dean and his honey pass away, and they rest in the village, and this is like the end of their life. And it's so beautiful where they rest. There's these white walls that are really intense, and I think that gives the end of this story that I had such a privilege to write and do a really good ending. So, as ghosts, like as themselves or whatever, they're resting there, or they're alive and living. I don't know, but I think the ghost version is good. So that is the James Dean story by Bella Landry. Thank you for listening.